So we are on our way to Ludlow, Colorado. It's what's left of a town that used to be a bunch of miners. So in 1913, the miners had had enough of the very rough conditions that they were working in, and they went on strike. In 1914, it came to a head with the Colorado Fuel and Iron Company, CF&I. It came to a head with them, and they called in the help of the National Guard. So there in Ludlow, you had a whole city of tent miners, meaning miners in tents. That's so intense. I can't get this right at all. Anyway, the miners who were living in tents in Ludlow, up to 1,200 miners there, were on strike for the poor mining conditions. And along comes the guards from the company. Here comes the man. Well, the man brings with him Colorado National Guard, and some shooting took place and some burning of tents. And what happened in the end were 25 people were killed. 11 of them were children. So we're going to show you that today. Well, not the killing of 25 people. We're going to show you what's left of Ludlow, Colorado. Hey, Gwen, what town are we going to?
Ludlow, Colorado.
Cool. And how's the driving experience?
Smooth.
Smooth?
No problems.
I'm kind of lumpy over here, but it might just be me. And what's our temperature?
54 degrees outside.
Huh. Pretty windy, as we discovered at the gas station. That view, though. Kids with spray cans. But it is a quiet place. Thank you. I could get the drone out. It just can't last with this kind of wind. Guess at what's here based on that, which is still standing. This is the way we used to make playground slides, out of strong steel. So I'm gonna guess that there's a school back there. Looks like a school building with the front entrance. I don't know what's behind it. Tower? I don't even know. Oh, if only I could fly the drone. I'd have answers to all this. Gwyn, read this sign to us.
Okay, looking onto this prairie, you see one of several places where coal miners lived during the strike. Miners demanded better wages, an 8-hour workday, a safe workplace, less company control over their lives, and the right to organize. After the United Mine Workers of America called the strike in September of 1913, the coal companies evicted thousands of miners and their families from their homes in company towns. The UMWA leased the land, provided tents, and even issued a small allowance. Ludlow was the largest tent colony with about 200 tents and 1,200 people. A culturally diverse group maintained solidarity during the strike. Local Hispanic people and European immigrants provided the majority of the labor force. People spoke at least 24 distinct languages. These different groups pulled together to form a community with a common goal. Violence on both sides plagued the strike. Governor Elias Ammons called out to the Colorado National Guard to help keep peace. By April 1914, membership in the local militia units consisted mostly of company employees who sided against the miners. On April 20th, 1914, hostilities came to a head, which resulted in the Ludlow Massacre. Throughout the day, the militia and miners exchanged gunfire. Lives were lost on both sides. Under suspicious circumstances, the tent colony burned. Two women and 11 children suffocated in a cellar dug beneath their tent, known as the Death Pit. The Death Pit and the monument serve as a memorial to those who lost their lives in the battle. While accounts differ, around 21 people died.
I read 25. Hey, now. That goes to show you, you can't trust anything you read on the internet.
Yeah.
Probably can't trust anything anywhere.
So where's the Death Pit?
The events of the Ludlow Massacre outraged the nation and embarrassed John D. Rockefeller Jr., the majority owner of the Colorado Fuel and Iron Company, the largest coal company operating in the area. This event initiated many of the labor reforms that workers now take for granted. As appeasement, Rockefeller introduced a plan that established a company-sponsored union, instituted procedures to air grievances, and improved the living conditions in the company towns. Well, nothing like being a little late to the party, John. Colorado Coalfield War Archaeological Project investigated and interpreted the Ludlow Massacre site. Historic archaeologists use both excavation and archival research to interpret the events, materials, and lifeways of the Ludlow tent colony so Marshall doesn't have to. This data informs the research and conclusions presented in this interpretive trail. So we interpret history. We don't really, like, know all of it. There's always more than one side to every story. Timeline of events. I'm not going to read all that to you. If you want to see all of this, then I'm sure there's a documentary somewhere, right? Or you can come here to Ludlow, Colorado, and enjoy this quiet place like we are. And here's the death pit, where women and children and some men were burned alive. Thanks to a greedy company with a lot of attitude.